I'm still telling my story.
Life story.
That was good.
No, we're still telling our life story.
We ought to just buy a bus and hit the road.
No, we don't. We should
you guys,
sell the bus.
We should sell the bus.
What bus?
Yeah. We don't have
don't
a bus.
Don't have one right now, do we?
Y'all, hello.
Hello, greetings. Y'all. These mics are on, aren't they?
We have a new album.
Yes, we do.
It's out.
Oh, my goodness.
Go
oh, my goodness.
Y'all,
cannot wait.
Life story available now.
That's right.
It's out now for all of you to listen to if you haven't already. Before you listen to this episode, stop this, pause this, go listen to the album, and then come back and listen to this episode.
Yeah, because there's some spoilers I should we should probably point out because we're going to talk about the songs.
Go listen to the album. We'll see you in 40 minutes.
Yes, that's right. So we're trying to shoot high here. We want billboards. Mm. We want platinum. Hey, we got to shoot high.
We want to break records.
We want to break records. We want our records to go aluminum.
Yeah.
Aluminum.
So anyway, y'all, but actually, it would be cool. We have had some success on the iTunes charts before. That was before streaming platforms, so I don't know if we're going to be able to do that.
It's not a thing anymore.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, and Keith, we're recording this obviously a little bit in advance.
Yep.
I mean, obviously the album's out now when y'all are listening to this, but who knows how it's going to do the actual 8th of March.
That's true. Maybe it's really good.
So, I mean, as of when people are listening to this, we'll know how it did, but right now we don't.
Hey there, and welcome to 4Ks in a Pod with the Erwins. My name is Luke, and I'm the producer of this podcast, and I'm so glad that you've joined us for this episode. Now, listening to the podcast is a wonderful way to get to know the Erwin family, but if you want to meet them in person, then you might be able to catch them live on tour. And if you want to find all of the different tour dates and seeing where you can catch them performing live, then you're going to want to head over to their website, erwinministries.com. Now, I'm really excited to introduce your co-host, Keith, Kody, Kris, and Katie. They are the 4Ks in a Pod.
Bring on the fire. Bring on the change from the valley to the mountain, he's worthy of praise. Whatever comes before me, I'm still telling my story. Whatever comes before me, I'm still telling my story.
So, guys, this is kind of the preview episode of our new record, Life Story. But before we go into further any more of that, maybe this is your first time listening to the podcast.
Welcome.
And so we want to give our brief mission statement to you guys, what we're trying to accomplish with this outlet, to build stronger friendships and to network these friends to other friends through various stories, fun topics, and enlightening interviews, all while glorifying Christ.
Amen.
That's what it's all about. That's what we want to do.
No doubt. And the Bible verse this week is Psalms 139:23. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts, and see if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting.
You know, I got to do it.
You got to do it.
You can't go wrong with song. Yep. You can't go wrong with song.
Yep.
The OGs, you know it.
You know it.
Right.
You know it.
It'd be like
we need
that.
To make that a sound so I don't have to do it every time. Make it a sound. You just hit the button.
Okay, we can do that.
That's kind of fun.
I will say, Kody, you've not hit the sounds much.
You know what I've noticed? Old Luke don't like it, I don't think.
Does he not?
I'm
shouting
sound?
Out. Yeah, because Luke. I haven't heard it in the. I haven't heard it. In
we
the,
haven't
oh,
done it
right.
though.
Yeah, I did it early in this in the like the start of this thing.
Yeah,
and I never heard them.
Well, we trust Luke.
Oh, they're
He's
not.
A pro.
They're probably
no, no,
not
no,
good.
No, they were in there.
Oh, were they?
Some of them, yeah.
Yeah, won't he do it? I've heard won't he do it.
I heard the won't he do it.
Maybe you don't listen to the podcast, Kody.
No.
Do you need to subscribe?
I listen to them sometimes.
And I heard the claps. The claps have been in a couple times.
Okay.
As well.
Oh, maybe I'm wrong then.
We have a new one. It was from. An interview thing that we did for Rodney Bauckham last time we recorded, and maybe we can play that sometime.
Yeah,
I don't know
will.
If we have it downloaded to the board yet, but
a little sneak peek.
A little sneak peek.
That's right. Yep, we'll get it.
That's what it was. Hey, y'all, let's get to some emails.
That's right.
Before we dive into
That's
this
That's one
album.
Of my favorite things that we've been able to do since we've started this podcast is it's a cool way to communicate.
Connect. Yep.
Yeah, and connect. We get those emails, and it goes directly to all of our phones.
And
so
they've been
cool
so kind to send us so many incredible emails. And a lot of prayer requests that we really appreciate because we want...
Some that, now, obviously, we're not going to necessarily put on the show, but we do still love receiving
all
this.
So Sherilyn Fowler, I've got one here. Okay, so I've been meaning to ask this when I see you guys in person, but I keep forgetting. Would y'all dive more into what it's like to create music sometime, like processes that you go through to make it happen that we don't hear, maybe don't know about?
Sherilyn, this is your episode,
this
baby.
This is it. Keep listening.
This is it.
Here's another the question, kind of a part of the same thing. What's the hardest part of songwriting? Is it coming up with the right lyrics, message, finding a melody, harmony that just makes a song come together, or something else? I imagine that coming up with words that would accurately describe how awesome God is and all things he's done, or showing the listeners exactly what he means to you through the words, would be the hardest, but maybe you have a different take. How do you choose which songs are more upbeat or more ballad-like? How do you sing a song that make it sound like the story that it was written to be and not just pretty words on a page? How much different is it to go from the studio to using the tracks and sound equipment on the road? That may be way too many questions.
These are big questions.
She says that may be way too many questions, so I'll stop there, but I can't wait to hear what y'all say. You know, those are all valid questions, very good questions.
A lot of the album questions, like when it comes to making the songs and stuff, we can answer in this episode a little bit later on once we dive more into it. I mean, a lot of us are just now getting started in songwriting, so we can't really answer. I personally can't really give a great answer on that. But honestly, it's kind of just, we talked about that though also in like Sue Smith's episode. It's kind of like just going into a room with friends.
Right.
You start brainstorming a little bit, start talking about different life experiences, and it falls into place.
And each person's different. Some people, you got to play into people's strengths. Like I'm horrible with words. It's one of those things where I'll sing something, but second guess words all day. But I can sit down on a piano and have a feeling of a melody and bring that out pretty quickly in any way, just because melody is definitely more my strong suit. But everybody's different. Every songwriter is different. Yeah. We talked about Sue, how she just go over into a corner and just stick to herself for 10 minutes and then come back with four different options that are just brilliant.
We talked about it with Wayne and Kenna as well, and Joseph, everybody's a little bit of different songwriting.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, great questions. Great questions.
Joy's Gonna Come. That was one that I had. We'll talk later.
Yeah, let's get into that later. We're gonna know that because some people might not know what Joy's Gonna Come is yet.
That's right. That's right. True. Maybe they didn't hear it.
We'll get to
the
album
email
soon.
I think we each have a
I have one here. It says, "My favorite episodes were the two with the Collingsworth siblings. How about more sibling groups on the podcast?"
No.
Love it. She has some recs here. The Browns, the Mylan Hayes fam, the Isaacs, the Taylors.
Nope, we're not having the Isaacs.
I mean, all of them.
We're not having the Isaacs. They're not invited or welcome on this podcast.
Another idea is to have more young artists. Would also like to hear stories about the songs Kris has written. Reminder, don't mention where I live on the podcast.
Yep.
Did you already say it?
No.
Nope.
I'm not saying
that's
anything.
Becca,
but
though,
it's
right?
Becca.
That's right.
We love you, Becca.
We love you, Becca. You know
those
we
are
and her
ideas.
Address is...
Hey, those are great ideas. I'd love to have
absolutely
more young people and more sibling groups. I think the sibling on siblings was a lot of fun. Really cool.
It was fun. And next time we need to have Courtney defend herself.
Yes.
We need
I
to
agree.
Actually... I think we need to have a follow-up episode of
with just Courtney.
Courtney.
The rebuttal. Yeah. We can call it the rebuttal.
Yeah.
For sure.
Have heard.
Thank you, Becca, for that email.
Yes, thank you,
we
Becca.
We love you.
We love you, Becca.
Anyone else?
Kris,
do you all have one?
You have one.
I got one.
Yeah.
Kody has one.
I have one. Brandon, also our Uber driver. You'll hear about that in a second.
Uber.
So you didn't learn this about me while we were together recently, but I have a bit of an unhealthy obsession with games.
Whoa.
To be ready for fun all time. All mm-hmm. times. To okay. be ready for fun at all
at
times.
All time,
sorry, I'm not reading right.
Got you.
The majority of my collection lives in the trunk of my car.
Wow.
Of the...
Whoa.
Of the trunk of my car. Most of the time. Which I furiously cleaned out when y'all were here, and I was occasionally being Uber.
Yes,
he was
were.
Occasionally being... He was more right. than occasionally being yep. Uber. We called him very much for Uber.
Too many times.
Yes. So do y'all play any games, board games, card games, while traveling on the bus? We don't. We don't see each other.
We are
on the
most boring people in the world.
Hey, but now look, around Christmas time and stuff, like whenever we are just off and home with nothing else to do and we actually do get together, which is rare. But around Christmas time, we play games like Monopoly.
We like
going
games.
Down.
Let's name one each. So you
Monopoly,
have I was going to name that one, but okay.
Going down, all of you.
Phase 10.
Phase 10.
Phase 10.
Dude, we went to Lindsay's family in Minnesota this past Christmas in the Minneapolis area. We went to we played Uno for hours.
Fun.
Uno for hours.
I'll say spades.
Spades,
good one.
Yeah.
Good one.
Love it.
It's a good one. It's a real good one. Okay,
we have
Kris.
A lot of games, but we don't play like on the road or anything like that.
We
but,
play hey, Mafia no. a lot.
Mafia on the cruise, us, you know. Which Brandon is going on the cruise with us next year.
Is he really? Oh, nice.
He and his
good.
Parents signed up.
That's great.
There you go. We won't need an Uber card there.
That's right.
We
have a boat. That's
so, great. Brandon, you'll get to learn yes. what Mafia is.
Brandon, thank you for the email, and thank you for being our Uber driver a couple of times when we were in Florida.
We love the Carters.
Ago. We yep. do. Great people. Great church. Thanota Sassa.
Hey, I learned. I talked about that yep. on the podcast, Thanota Sassa, and it's yep. actually Thanota Sassa.
Thanota Sassa. We were overthinking it.
And we're also saying where Brandon's from.
Yep.
We didn't right. say a state, did we? Well, that's okay.
There are a lot of Brandons there.
There's a lot of Brandons. Didn't give his last name.
No, we didn't.
We do. We're trying to be better at not giving people's last names.
Christopher, do you have an email?
I do. This email says, hello from Lafayette, Georgia, which is about 20 minutes away from Ringgold, which is cool Georgia. Since that's where Katie's husband is from.
Oh, go Dogs.
I'm Kaylee. I met y'all at Arise 2022. Really? It was such a joy getting to hear you sing and getting to meet you in person. I remember walking up to y'all's table before the service, and only Keith and Kody were at the table at
Imagine
the time.
That. Surprise.
Keith. Wow.
We just talked about this.
Let's get into that. I wanted to get a picture with them anyway, and they were... Wow, I love
yep.
that.
anyway.
I love how she specified that it was just you two, and then she said, following right after that, I went ahead and got a picture with them anyway.
Yeah, that's nice.
Obviously not the one she wanted. Here we go. Where were we at? Anyway, they were so shocked. They were so shocked that I wanted to take a picture with them.
Yeah, nobody does.
I'm not kidding. What is this?
Kaylee.
Keith told me that I took the very first Keith and Kody picture.
That's true.
That's fact. Which is amazing in my opinion. I believe it.
I wouldn't brag about that, Kaylee.
That is gold.
No, she's bragging.
Yeah, hold on to that. I did come back after the service and get a picture with the entire group, but I thought that was a nice little story.
It is a nice story. The one with the group will be cheaper to buy.
Please. She has a few questions. Okay. What do you do to prepare to sing for a service mentally and physically? Keith, not enough. Katie? I'm kidding.
I drink a lot of water during the days. Don't sleep enough. But besides that.
Mentally, that's what I would say. Sleep. You've got to get your rest before you sing. Yeah. It's tiring, y'all. Y'all don't know if. Y'all realize it, but...
It's a lot.
Y'all don't know if y'all realize it.
A lot of y'all drink tea. Keith drinks tea, like, up to the time we sing.
Throat coat tea, specifically.
But y'all don't drink sodas, do you?
No.
Oh. So we don't do
I
sodas.
Do at I night do. After a concert. I will. You won't catch me drinking a Coke.
We avoid
before.
Sodas. So there's honestly, there are prices to pay for...
Well, and food.
Sing as much as we do, at least.
And food. I mean, not only drinks, but like food. You can't go and eat a big old greasy cheeseburger before
we
singing.
We used to be able to.
Can't do that.
Remember when we were young? We used to do whatever we
Kody,
wanted.
Kody, our bass singer, is making faces over here.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't believe anything.
But you
that.
Have the easiest part.
Wow. We.
Me too. It's true.
Kody,
you don't even sing
you
bass
can
that
stick
much.
Your face in the bus exhaust and then walk on stage and probably sound better.
That's talent. That has nothing to do with
Jeff Easter. Well, yeah, you've seen it firsthand.
Me and Jeff are a lot alike.
Guys, I'll tell y'all this.
You're low maintenance.
Y'all remember being on the Celebration
Cruise? You
just get
up there and sing, man.
Y'all remember being on the Celebration Cruise 10 years ago, and that was the first time we met Jody McBrayer. And we were sitting at a table with Jody. I don't know if all four of us were there. I remember so vividly this story.
From the incredible group Avalon.
Absolutely. Jody McBrayer is one
Jody
of the best
here.
Vocalists yeah, in the world. Amazing. Yes. But, dude, I'll never forget when he said this. And he didn't say it like being cocky. But he was saying this in the most genuine way. I was talking like this. It's basically Kaylee's same question. I said, man, how do you do this? Like, you're a powerhouse. He said, when you got it, you got it.
Yeah.
That's what he said.
Jody.
I'm like, you know what? And I'm saying that knowing full well that no four of us have it.
No. Yeah. We got to work for it.
Because we have to work for
it. We got to work for whatever
but
we
there
have.
Are people, as Katie's saying, like Jeff Easter, and people like yeah. that, I'm sure that we
Kody,
know.
Kody, evidently.
Yeah, well, I don't know about that.
Yep. But there,
yep. there I mean, he just said it.
There are people that just
first
can
step
do
conference.
Whatever. For, do whatever. Yeah. And unfortunately, it's not me because I've got to watch what I eat. I've got some acid reflux issues.
I think everybody's different.
Everybody's
different.
Oh, absolutely.
For sure.
And with that, you have people that are unicorns
yeah.
that can eat and drink whatever they want before they
yeah.
sing.
Yeah, I don't know that it matters. It probably does matter. Saying it doesn't matter is not the right word.
Right.
I think yep. everybody's different. And
I agree.
That you just got to learn your body and learn your throat and learn your placements and learn your breathing and learn what it takes to get you through the concert or service that night.
That's right.
I mean, clearly, you got to pray and you got to get right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Spiritually. Absolutely.
Spiritually, there's a lot that goes into it as well.
But mentally and vocally, it doesn't matter. She has another question.
Oh, yeah.
Chichi, go ahead.
Kaylee ain't done.
Kaylee.
Come on, Kaylee.
Kaylee.
Yeah, if we were from up north, Kaylee.
For Kris. Oh, no, we can skip that one.
No, Kris.
Oh, we want to know. No, we can.
It was when writing a song, when does your writing process, what is your writing process?
What does your writing process?
When writing a song, what is your writing process? Nope. What does your writing process look like? What advice would you give for someone who is wanting to start writing music? Reconsider.
Christopher, and that goes along with what our friend Becca asked as well.
That's true.
Yep.
So you have a lot of people wanting to know about your writing process. None of ours. Yours.
Well, let me just go ahead and say this.
Talk about writing, your own podcast, Kris.
No, let me go ahead and say this. I don't really know the writing process. I'll tell you this, Kaylee.
I'll tell you. Sue Smith covered a lot of this.
Oh, yeah.
In fact, I remember distinctly one of her answers to one of our questions. It was really the same question, Kaylee, that she just asked. Is talking about you have to have thick skin. You have to have thick skin to be a writer, is what she said. If you remember.
Which is so ironic because Sue was also a writer on this song that we were talking about. It was me, Kris, and Sue. And shoot. What's her name? Help me.
The other writer.
Oh, she wrote for Natalie Grant.
Yeah.
Huge name. Why am I not? I'm blanking right now.
But you need to not because you need to know.
I'm blanking.
Kris.
Chrissy Nordhoff. Nordhoff. Oh,
yeah. Great.
She wrote Your Great Name by Natalie Grant.
Oh, my goodness.
Ooh. So good.
It took a little long, but we got her name.
That's her name, Chrissy.
Hey, guys, first of all, thank you so much for the emails and all of the input, all the questions, all the prayer requests. I want to give the email address one more time. It's the word for, F-O-U-R, the letter K, the word pod, 4kpod@yahoo.com. We would absolutely love to read your questions, your comments, anything you may have for us. We would love to interact with you. It's an honor for us to do that. That's, like I said, in this mission statement, one of the main reasons we do this podcast is to interact with our friends. And so please send your emails, and we would love to talk with you.
And we want to know what your favorite song is. This episode is all about life story.
That's right.
We are about to dive so deep into the swimming pool of life story.
And it's deep.
It's real deep. Like, way too deep. But
maybe too deep.
We want to know what your favorite song is. After you listen to this full episode and listen to us kind of dive in and break apart each song, send us an email today, right now, when this episode's over, saying what your favorite song is on the album and why. That's what I want to know.
Yep. And the first song that we had, that I think the first song that we put on hold was it Back to the Garden?
I believe so. I want to go down the list, like, start to finish.
Okay, like in the sequence of the record.
If someone is sitting down listening to the album.
Perfect. That's
how that went. Is there anything that we want to mention about the recording process from the beginning? I know we've kind of said it's been, like, a long time in the making.
Yeah.
3 years. Took us a long time, you guys.
Yeah. So just the song search process, over 1,200 songs, I think, is what we figured out that we listened to. Over and over again. In fact, what's kind of funny, I might have said this before, but in my email, I've got a list, a folder in my email that says songs for 2022 record. Wow. No, I'm sorry. It says songs for 2023 record. And so you're talking, it's 2024. The record is just now getting out. So it's been a long process.
It's crazy.
And for so many reasons that are out of our control, it's all understandable. And in God's timing also, we were really looking for these songs. And we make it a very serious point to find the exact songs we're supposed to sing in the exact season that we're in.
It's not hard to find the amount of songs.
No.
The quantity of...
Or quality songs.
No. Yeah, that's right.
The right songs.
It's just a matter of where we're at, what we want to say. And that's important.
For instance, you could also have too many fast songs, too many slow songs. Like, you're looking for a certain thing to fit the mold of this album that it's kind of hard.
I think that's why, not to interrupt you, but I think that's why artists write so much individually, like they write for that album. Yeah. It's because that's where they're living. That's what they're trying to say. They need this fast. They need this slow. They need this ballad. They need, you know.
Yeah. And another pro of writing your own music is you can keep it on hold for another album.
True.
Yep.
And so who knows what you'll be hearing.
Kick off of what Kody said, only the artists know as good as anybody about what you need on stage.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, the sequence, during your song selection process, during your programming process, which is what I normally do every night, what do we need? And that's kind of what we were trying to working on as we went forward. And
I think this album is going to really accomplish a lot with the set.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's going to help us have different feels. I mean, there's so many different kinds of songs on this album, too. And a lot we're working on. We might be releasing again soon. Who knows?
That's right.
With more of that.
We're always working, and we're trying to get the right concert. We're trying to make the right records. And, buddy, I hope and pray that this is what's happened with this one.
Yeah. I do want to say Stowtown Records
outdid themselves.
They killed this thing. And we have to give full credit to our producer, the best there is. You guys know him from the podcast, Wayne Hahn.
That's right.
Absolutely did an incredible job. And it's also the executive producers were also Landon Bean and Ernie Haas. So I want to give them credits as well. The three presidents of our amazing label, Stowtown Records.
And before you even listen to the music, you're looking at the wonderful, you know, artwork.
Yes.
Pictures.
All of that's design, listed.
All that's listed. Yeah, all that matters. I mean, this takes a whole village to make one of these things happen. Mm. So, and we have, I think, in my personal opinion, some of the best people in the world.
I love all the colors.
Yeah. And,
it pops.
It does, which man. Yeah. And we did that some with This Is Love. You know, that was one of our, and favorites on repeat. That was one of our, you know, we're trying to get it bright and colorful and happy and try to make it, you know, where something pops, you know.
Yeah.
Just a few people here. I want to give credit to Mary Alice.
Absolutely.
Mary
please.
Alice Lovelace.
Read all of that.
Okay. All right. Let's go down the list here. Tracks recorded by Randy Pool at Pool Room.
Yep. Right.
That was a fun day. I love tracking.
He had a beautiful little dog.
Yes. Vocals recorded by Leah. That's and right. I'm going to butcher her last name.
Say it.
Shat Schneider.
There we go.
I feel like that was that'll close. Work.
I feel like close. It is Shat Schneider.
Maybe Shot Schneider. Yeah. I don't know.
And then Brandon Epps also there at Treasure Isle in Nashville.
Talked to Brandon yesterday.
Love him. Y'all, they did great. Orchestra recorded by Joe Carroll.
Oh, my goodness.
And also Leah Shat Schneider. Shat Schneider. And Brandon Epps.
We love you, Leah.
At Treasure. All of that was done at Treasure Isle there in Berry Hill, Nashville area.
A little bit of a backdrop on the studio.
Mm-hmm.
Treasure Isle is the only studio that Jason Aldean will record vocals in because he just likes the room. And that's kind of what it is. You know, different studios have different feels, different feel and sounds in every studio. And these artists will come in and do different
vocals.
I've
never heard of Jason Aldean. I only listen to Christian music.
That's true. But they will have different, and they'll just like different
studios.
Another
one is James Taylor. James Taylor does like several albums at Treasure Isle as well.
And the back of Treasure Isle is right up next to the back of Blackbird Studio, which is where every country artist records.
That's right.
There in Berry Hill. Great restaurants over there too.
Mixed by Scott Williamson at Carpool Tunnel in Franklin, Tennessee.
Wow.
I did not know that was the what?
That, is that what he's called? Carpool Tunnel?
That's at the Carpool Tunnel.
I like it.
That's what his studio is called.
We love Scott Williamson. Play on words. Absolutely. I just didn't know his studio was called
That's called.
That's cool.
I dig it.
Thank you, Scott.
Mastered by Alan Silverman at ARF Mastering in New York City, New York.
Oh, my soul. That's where this thing was mastered.
It was mastered in New York City.
Goodness.
By Alan. Alan Silverman. Thanks, Alan.
Thank you, Alan, for your work. I want to go visit you.
All right, let's go down the musicians here.
Yep.
Okay, so we got Kris Crunk with programming.
Fantastic.
Makes us sound really cool, cooler than we are. Scott Williamson, who also mixed it. I just mentioned Scott. He played the drums on this album.
Super funny guy.
He's great.
He's good in the seas. He's a fun hang.
We've got Jason Webb and Gordon Mote on piano. Woo! Y'all, fighting for you. Jason Webb's.
Get there.
I'm sorry. I had to put that in. Jacob Lowry and Mark Hill on the bass.
That's right.
Incredible, guys.
Incredible.
Joel Key and Kevin Williams on acoustic guitar.
Yep.
Mike Payne and Kelly Back and Dave Cleveland on the electric guitar.
Kelly Back and Joel Key have done keys, not keys, I'm sorry, played guitar on most of our records, of our Stowtown records. Those two guys, you would see their names. Jason Webb, of course, if it's not Gordon Mote, it's Jason Webb. One of those two guys are normally doing keys. But man, I love both of them. And Jason, I'm telling you, as Christopher said and Katie said, kind of hinted at one of the songs, I think one of his best works he's ever done.
Oh my goodness.
And it's cool to work with them. It seems like, he said, they've worked on our music before and it's like they have a feel for us. We have a feel for them.
Yeah.
And it's like a hand in glove. I know they work on thousands a week, it seems like, but, it's cool to have them play on multiple records for an artist. I'm sure it's cool for them too, because they kind of go along with the artist, you know, as really cool.
Tracking Day is one of my favorites, y'all. Orchestra Contractors. I should not be the one reading this, you guys.
You're doing great. Katie.
Okay. Orchestra Contractors. David Davidson and Mike Castile.
Thank you, David and
y'all.
Mike.
Yes. Orchestral Copyists is Michelle Gayhart and Mike and Lori Castile.
Michelle Gayhart. You know, she just kind of retired from her position at Stowtown.
Really?
She did. And so a big shout out to her. She's
still
had to work with us.
She has her name on here.
She does.
She has her name. Probably
her name is carrying on with our ministry. So
Orchestral
she's awesome.
Is that how you pronounce that? Orchestral?
Correct. It is.
Orchestral librarian is Leah's sister,
yep.
Haley Schatznyder.
That's right.
Another, yep. Oh, we love you, Haley.
Yes,
we spent
do.
A lot of time with you in the studio and at Brothers.
And yes, and Haley actually continued what Michelle does.
Yeah, she's doing so a lot of like Haley, the designing and the right. graphics and the stuff.
Yep. And a lot of the paperwork, though, too, Stowtown. With Stowtown. Yeah,
correct.
A lot of the paperwork.
And quite the artist herself, right?
Absolutely. Singer. Great singer.
Look her up. Haley Schatznyder.
That's right.
And I'm not going to go into how you spell it. Look up Haley.
Spell
well,
it.
I can. Let me do that. Haley Schatznyder. It's C. No, it's S.
C.
You started laughing as soon as you were reading it.
Haley S-C-H-A-T-T-S-C-H-N-E-I-D-E-R.
Doom, 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 doom. Like the good pacing
luck,
of that. That's good.
Yeah. We're not going to tell people the last name. We're just going to spell it.
All right. Here we
it's different.
There's only a few more here that I want to go down. The yes. production management is Michelle Gayhart for Stowtown Records. Production assistance is Haley Schatznyder.
Yep.
Art direction is Mary Alice Lovelace for Stowtown Records. Mm. Photography.
Sounded out.
Just spell it again.
Jeremy Ryan Creatives in Nashville, Tennessee, y'all. And he, yep. I think this is some of the funnest
yep.
pictures I've ever seen him do. Mm. And he does a lot for Stowtown.
Yes, he does. Oh, yeah.
A lot of the Stowtown
artists.
He's easy to work
with. A lot for yeah. everybody.
He's a great guy.
It's
He's
very
good.
Fresh, very fun. Yep. We've gotten so many compliments
yes, we have.
On the album cover, and that's all because of Jeremy.
That's
so
right.
we thank you, Jeremy. We love you.
And Landon.
And Landon and Taranda
oh,
and Mary Alice.
Oh, my goodness.
That room was full that day
it's
on our photo
day.
Shoot
yep.
day.
Y'all remember they didn't tell so us fun. They were going to shoot those guns, those confetti guns, until...
Not much of a warning.
Somebody asked me, they said, was that stage like photoshopped in, like the
no.
confetti?
Yeah.
It was literally like four people yeah. literally shooting
on
these. Like you've seen them at weddings, I'm sure, or like ball games maybe. And it's this loud, like, pop, like, you know, it goes off.
We have a video somewhere.
Yeah, we'll have to post it.
We do.
Yes, we have
we'll
a video it. Of it.
Well, as you can, if you look at the picture, the artwork, you can see on the bottom, there's quite a bit already on the ground.
That
because
was
let's
previous.
Just say that yeah. they did not use the first few
no,
takes.
No, we didn't.
The first few
pictures. We didn't even know, like, the shooting yeah. range of them. We didn't know
it
how.
Was, it was loud. Hard. It was not a big room.
Yeah.
Nope. It's Jeremy's no. house,
that's
I believe.
Right. Yes,
it's his apartment.
Studio. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it's
four
loud
more.
In there.
I got four
Go ahead.
More.
Go ahead.
Hair and makeup by my best friend Heather Rose Jordan.
That's right.
She killed it. Graphic design by Derek Walker at dnub.com. Did a great job. We just talked
yes.
about that.
Yes.
Licensing is Cindy Ballard for Stowtown Records, and then account management is Nate Goebel.
Nate.
For the Nate. So guys, so let's just make this clear. I know most of you guys, that might have been like hearing people just
credit
read
at the end of
Leviticus.
The movie.
Yeah, yeah, or read somebody read Leviticus and like you're like,
right.
okay, it's but let me tell you, this record is whatever success it has is going to be because of those people
yeah.
we just named. Because
right.
they have told us what to do. They have kind of pushed us in the position of what to do. Their wisdom, their expertise, these people, none of these people started yesterday. They've been around for a long time, and we just want to praise the Lord for their talents, because that's the reason really why we are where we're at. So
that's right.
The Lord and these people, it's literally the way, the reason we're here. So,
so everyone so we just listed, we thank you guys so much
Absolutely.
For all of your hard work, your endless hours that you've thrown into this album. We do appreciate it
yep.
so much.
Yes, ma'am.
No doubt.
Perfect. So much.
Absolutely. Let's get into the songs.
You want to go song by song?
Let's do it.
All right, so we are starting off. If you put in the Life Story CD into your car right now, you will hear...
Drum beats.
Yeah, literally, a drum beat. And it is called Taste and See is the first song. And the words and music is by Jaron Davis and Kay Van Matre.
That's right.
Matre? I think
maybe
I did
Mater?
That, right?
I don't know.
Mater, Matre? Matre sounds fancy.
Yeah, Matre. I bet it is because Padre
mm-hmm.
Would be with a D, though. I'm sure it's probably the same.
So Jaron has written a couple on this album.
Yep.
But this is one of my favorites that Jaron has ever written.
That's exactly
that
right.
I've heard.
Great, great start of a concert, great start of a record. That's with every record, you really, the first big song, I think to me, my mindset normally is in this process is you've got to find a starter. Every record has got to have a starter because you want to have that fresh song with every record.
Yeah.
Especially with us because we've kind of had the idea a few records ago of doing intro videos and different things for concerts. So it's even more paramount that we find a song that would do that. And Taste and See is what's going to be. I think every record needs to have a starter like that. Every record needs to have a big power ballad. And every record needs to have some songs with energy. And I hope and pray that we've done all of that. And I know we've accomplished that first one with an intro, like it's intro to a concert, a first, you know, first song to a concert. So starter.
I think it sounds like The Lion King.
It did. It did.
And it's also to have that feel, to have that beat, but the words are amazing.
It's
absolutely.
So
I mean, just the same thing we do with Story Ends. Yeah. It's very, the words are fantastic. Great
come
melody.
Yeah. Oh, come to him. Oh, yes. I like it. I think it's very
fantastic.
It's very much that vibe.
That's the live version.
And very theatrical. The I really like Taste and See, and I can't wait to start singing it live.
Jaron's great. Jaron, like Katie said, has a couple of cuts on this record.
He does.
And he's the one that wrote, he wrote other songs like We Are Standing on Holy Ground and In the Presence of Jehovah.
All of My Help.
Yes, All of My Help. And then My Testimony song, Same Grace. And so, yeah.
And then also another one on here that we will get to later on.
And he's got a ministry of his own, not just songwriting.
That's right.
Jaron Davis and Kindred Souls. That's right. Mm-hmm. And I believe that's his wife singing and his somebody. I know it's his family. It's his family. Look them up. Jaron Davis and Kindred Souls. They're real fantastic.
Good.
Absolutely.
Real, real good. And yes, they actually have their own cut of Back to the Garden.
Yes.
And it's really good. If you look it up on YouTube, you can listen to it as well. Beautiful. Nice. Beautiful,
well,
beautiful.
Not to that song yet.
No, sorry. Spilling the beans early.
No, it's okay.
Hey,
it's okay.
Let's get on to song number two. Try to get this moving because I know we have a lot to unpack here.
Yep.
Still Telling My Story, which has been the longest released song, I guess, from this album. We released this back in May of 2023. Yeah. Still Telling My Story, words and music by Kevin Weinbarger, Wendy Ferguson, Jeremy Rodriguez, and Ryla Harrison Clark.
Man.
Love it.
Yeah. I remember sitting in the, we were in a writing room in Nashville at Word, actually, with Wayne, mm-hmm. when he first played this demo and said he just got this, in, and he had sent it. He said he'd saved it for Kana's Voices album. And we were like, no.
Sorry.
Yeah, don't do that. even though I would have loved to have heard them destroy this song, I'm glad that they sent it over our way.
Destroy in a good way.
Yeah, I mean, that is a compliment, of course. but Still Telling My Story, it's been so fun to sing it live across the country. And I'll say this. I don't know if I can speak on behalf of all four of my siblings, or all three of my siblings, but this is one song that I have noticed people sing along to more than almost any other song between, like, maybe Watch and See. Maybe that's a close second, but other than Watch and See, Still Telling My Story, like, anytime we sing it, no matter where we are, there are a lot of people singing along, which is really cool.
It's really, really cool.
That means that it's translating and working.
Yes, it is. Sure. And yeah, and we've been singing this song since last May.
Yeah.
That's when it was released.
And we have the video that kind of cuts in after the second chorus.
Yeah.
That's right.
Second chorus comes in. People love that.
And if you guys haven't heard the extended versions that we have,
there's three.
It's only on streaming. It's not on the new album, which is kind of different.
Yep.
But you can look it up on Spotify. It's even on YouTube, Apple Music, anything like that. Extended testimony version and acoustic version.
Like our dear friends, Carrie Nelson, Tyler Kaysen, and Coach G, Alex Guerra at Edgewood ISD. That's right. The head football coach there.
It's powerful. It's something that you really need to listen to if you haven't. Yeah. It's incredible. And of course, we do it live at any venue or church that has screens. We'll do the extended version. So,
Song number three.
One of my favorites, y'all. One of my favorites.
And this is my favorite.
And we're getting early reviews that it's other people's favorites also.
Yeah, we started singing this one a couple weeks ago, a little bit early. This is None But Jesus, and it's words and music by Blake Walker, Marsha Henry, and Devin Cunningham.
That's right.
Y'all, this song is something special.
And Blake Walker's pretty new to the songwriting scene from what I can understand. I know that in the last couple years we've started hearing his name, and just an anointed writer. And he's become a great friend of ours in the last couple of years. He's come to see us a few times. It's not his only song on the record
no,
either.
No, it's not.
And so he's one of the few guys that have a couple of different cuts on this record. But
you know, it's funny, not to interrupt you, it's kind of funny that you hear somebody's writing and it's like they're right in the niche with you.
Yeah.
So like sometimes we only have one writer and it goes like years, or it seems like we don't have another cut.
Yeah.
And then Blake gets two on the same record.
That's right.
You know, it's like
kind of what happened
there for a while. Rachel McCutcheon, for Ready to Sell and Only Faith and See.
We Kevin did so Weinbarger. Many of
those. This one and last one, we did a lot of Kevin, because Kevin did Still Telling My Story.
Yep.
He did on this one. He's done.
He did a lot for the This Is Love album already on his Way God, stuff like that.
Yes, he did.
He didn't do Walking Free.
Nope, he didn't do Walking Free. Yeah. But yeah, we'll get to that song. We'll get to that song.
More to come on that.
And but in contrast to Blake though, Marsha Henry she's had her name all over the place.
Right.
You can look up. She's had her name for years and years. The Wisnets have had many songs of hers. My goodness, I know the Hoppers have had good songs of Marsha's. Many other the Mylan Hayes family have had a lot of Marsha Henry songs.
Yeah.
And so her name's everywhere, and I know I'm missing people. But anyway, so and then Devin Cunningham.
I know I've heard his name too in other songs too, but yeah, it's going to be a ballad. We're probably going to finish every concert with that song just by early reviews. It does take a month or two really to figure out where each song is going to sequence in a concert. And that's kind of the mystery of this whole time that we're in, is trying to place the songs in the right positions, not only for them, obviously, most importantly to the Holy Spirit to use them in the most effective way that he can, but also for us to do the songs right, to do the song service and exactly where we put them in the sequencing, because that not only helps the song, it affects us, it helps us, and it helps the movement of the Holy Spirit. So we try to get everything in alignment. That's the word when you're looking for sequencing and programming.
That's right. I think what's really cool too about this specific song and the arrangement of it is how Wayne made us have a verse. Like each of us have one verse.
That's right.
It's something you don't get to see a lot in our circle or even the Erwin specifically.
Yeah.
So I think it's kind of cool that we each get to share a part of this song individually.
Yeah, and that's something we're going to try to incorporate not only on singing, but talking. Mm. I think one of my favorite things that I've done in the last couple of years is listen to one of our favorite groups in the world, and would be a great interview, the Martins.
Mm.
If you remember going to the concert a couple of years ago
in
Waxahachie, each one of them talked and set up a different song. Right now, it's kind of Keith heavy. I'll be honest. It's kind of Keith heavy.
We used to do more, though. Like, I used to set up shoes every night.
That's right.
Kris has scars.
I used
scars.
To talk a lot more.
Wait.
Not scars. Yeah. You had, like, God's Already There. That's back in the day, though.
This ain't going to work.
I used to be, like, the main MC.
It's not going
to
work.
No, I don't want to talk. I can't remember my words that go
guys, I need the individual to know. If you all think singing in front of people is nerve-wracking, you get up there and try to talk.
Singing is easy.
Talking is where it gets hard. Because that's just more.
If you memorize, I know it sounds terrible, but if you memorize something, it's really easy.
Well, yeah. That's
I mean, like, I memorized
Keith. That's the same as singing. If you know what you're going to say.
Exactly.
Yeah, if you know what you're going to say, it's one thing. You
like,
can just
I've memorized,
it.
And I'm sure a lot of you OGs and you regulars that come to see us a lot, which is great, we love it, have also memorized my intro for Keith. Like,
well,
Tucker.
No. Hey, I recommend if you have nerves.
Oh yeah,
you got to know what you're going to say.
Yeah,
know what you got to say. You
That's
know what I mean?
True.
But if you just want to get up there and just freestyle, that's when it gets
messy.
Scary.
Yeah,
it's messy.
No doubt. Yeah, you have to mentally. You have to be there. You have to be engaged.
Mm.
And
I see what Kris is saying. The best MCs out there can just off the cuff.
Mm. Well, it's all
know
about
where they're
the
ending
audience.
And then create something out of there and get.
Well, it's like Jeff Easter. Jeff Easter, he's so good at breaking down the walls with anybody, no matter where he is. No matter what type of audience, he'll just immediately he'll
get up
and just talk. And that's what he literally told me. I said, how do you do it? How do you just connect with people immediately? He said, well, all you do is get up there and talk to them.
Just exactly like, right.
Just, that's, all you can do is just talk to them.
Nope. Tracy Stuffel always was such a master at that. With how he, and that's what he said.
Yeah,
kind of similar. He said, just act like you're sitting at a table talking
talk
with
them.
And Tracy was such a master. Gerald Wolf is fantastic at it.
Phil Collingsworth is really good at it.
You're talking about people who've been doing it for
Eric Bennett.
Absolutely.
Years.
Eric Bennett.
Oh, my
Eric
goodness.
Bennett's
Eric Bennett.
Good.
And yeah, exactly, Kris. You're
talking. Decades talk, to
yeah,
it, accumulate
it, they
that.
Didn't jump off, yeah. They didn't jump off this and get on stage yesterday for the first time. And these guys have been doing it for
Pat
years.
Pat Barker is
who?
I don't know.
I don't know who that is.
Yeah, oh, yeah, it's true.
Hey, let's move right along. Let's keep moving down the album here. On the fourth song, you have... Oh, sorry. Yeah, fourth song, you have Back to the Garden.
The other Jaron Davis cut.
Yeah.
Written, this is a close...
Sorry, go ahead. This is words and... Sorry, I want to get this before I forget. Words and music by the Queen. Charity Gell.
Yep.
Ryan Kennedy and Jaron Davis.
Charity and Ryan, that's husband and wife.
Yes,
that's
it
Charity's
is.
Charity's
husband. And I am a charity girl.
Oh, my goodness.
Instead of Charity Gell, I'm a charity
publicist.
Girl.
I'm a charity person myself.
Woo!
She's my, and I know it's well documented on this podcast, the record that has I Speak Jesus on it.
So
is that your favorite record?
That's a top five.
No way. I'm
never.
Top
one of your five record of all time. Like I said, I know it's well documented, but it needs to be presented.
I want to address something. The past two episodes, I've said the same song and share a song, and I apologize. But for this episode, I don't know if any of y'all want to share a song real quick, but I want to share another Charity Gell song that just came out. It's called Because of Jesus.
That's another segment we do later, isn't it?
We usually do it at the beginning. We kind of skipped over it.
Oh, no.
So the only reason I shared it now is because I did the same song twice.
Did you really?
You want to make sure you're not doing that.
And I want to address
That's
that.
A good way.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to, but I just, like I said, I'm a Charity Gell.
We'll forgive you.
Charity Gell.
Charity Gell.
You did this.
Girl.
She needs to put that on a shirt.
This,
Charity Gell.
This song, Back to the Garden, though, I remember we were sitting on it with bated breath because we just knew it was such a good song that we just knew
it was going to be taken from us.
Or for months.
Like, yeah, we just charity. Knew that sitting on it, we were like, someone's going to take this if we don't for hurry months. And cut this.
Yeah,
we were scared to death, but I'm thankful. And obviously, there have been other people. Yeah, Brother Jared, the guy who wrote it, obviously, he has a very, as Katie mentioned a minute ago, a wonderful rendition of it. Yeah. And if I wrote the song, I wouldn't skip on it either. But we were scared. We were scared that it was about to be released. You
and
know,
I'm low-key kind of hoping that way. Charity releases one day.
She will.
I'm
not?
Sure she will.
She
this skip? Song is doing
This was
incredible.
Honestly another sneak peek into this album.
Sneak peek.
Is this was, for the longest time, this was going to be the title cut in a way. That album was going to be entitled The Garden.
That's right. There was a chance.
I wanted
but
it.
But it turns
so
out
bad.
We couldn't do The Garden because that's a cult.
I didn't know.
Apparently.
Oh, really? I never heard that.
There's a,
and
there's
I bet a
cult
lot of you listening
somewhere
don't know.
There. Yeah. Well, there apparently is a cult out there called The Garden, so we couldn't really associate our album with
Come on, people. Come listen to
We may
to
grow
the
our
garden.
Fan base in a way we
or
don't
we
really want to.
Or we could have got a whole new fan base.
Yes. Hey, they got to be reached somehow.
That's right.
They got to be reached
Hashtag
somehow.
Them or something.
We had like 200,000 new followers on Instagram. Just a bunch of people wearing all white showing up to the Erwin's concert.
Well, this is weird.
Okay.
Welcome.
Back to The Garden is another song, though, that was released a little bit before the album, so a lot of you might have memorized it and learned it and maybe even sung it yourself now. So I love Back to the Garden. We've been singing it for a couple weeks and it's just really ministering.
It's a single
to
right
a
now.
Lot of people.
That's right. It's a heavy single. Song. It's a heavy song. It's a song of revival. It's a song of self-examination to see where you are with Christ and if you are in full fellowship with our Lord. And I'll tell one of my favorite things about this song and for you listeners who are maybe never heard this song live yet, and it happened again Sunday, that as when the song is over, and this is not anything that we can just make happen. But when the song is over, there's just a stillness.
Mm.
I guess, and obviously we don't ask for this, but naturally when every song's over, they just, people start clapping.
Yeah.
But this song, just a stillness.
I think it's so deep.
And,
people just don't
goodness.
Know. Like,
well, but I'm thankful for that because that means that it is registering with people. That was that. I'll be honest with you. That was not a worry, but something that I was interested in seeing is this song going to be so deep or so challenging that people are really going to want to get on that level. But you know what? Thank the Lord that God is using it in a way that I knew He could, and I know that He is. And so
there's like
praise
a hush.
Lord. Absolutely,
at the end of
a stillness. And it's we praise the Lord for it. That means That's God's right. using it, and we hope and pray that that continues to happen.
Love it. Number five, we have Red Words, and it's Words and Music by Barbara Huffman and Rodney Griffin.
Yes. He's written a tune or two.
He
Who would have thought?
I mean,
how many years in a row?
I don't know. I should have looked at it.
Almost our whole existence.
15 or 16 years consecutively of songwriter of the
I
year.
I want to say 21.
Yeah, I think it's
Is it that many times? I'll tell you this. I've told, I guess, I mean, nobody literally has never asked me anything, but I would say I would just name that thing, the Singing News, the Rodney Griffin Singing News Songwriter
name
of the Year Award.
Name it after him, yeah.
Name it after him after 20 years or whatever.
He'd win his own award.
And that's what he probably would.
Yeah.
But name it after him, man, because I'm telling you, he's a machine. And the healthy thing about his writing is there's many songs that you would hear that you're like, man, that doesn't sound like a Rodney Griffin song.
Yeah.
And obviously there may be some songs, especially done by Greater Vision, because it's one group and they have the sound, a distinct sound, and maybe, that's a Rodney Griffin song. But then you'll hear other artists do one of his songs and be like, I cannot believe that's a Rodney Griffin
that's
song.
That's how talented he is.
He's incredible.
Yeah.
And humble, unassuming, one of my favorite guys.
When we were little kids, one of our favorite songwriters to sing a song from was Rodney Griffin when we were little kids.
Absolutely.
I mean, we grew up singing He Is to Me, There Is. Yep.
We would run around the Quartet Convention and Dad would ask people like Rodney and Gerald.
Yeah.
And
to think
that
we have one of our own now
original.
Is
that incredible?
Yeah.
Crazy.
And the guy has sent me probably 100 songs.
There's a lot.
And a lot of good songs, a lot of fantastic songs. But it just wasn't right for either a record or wasn't right for the time.
It's like what we talked about early on this episode.
It is.
Like
every
just
writer,
wait.
Every writer even knows more about that than we do.
Yep.
And correct me if I'm wrong, guys. This was, I believe, our last selection. And that sometimes you think, well, that was that was one they were kind of on the fence for. When we heard it, we knew we wanted to do it.
Yep.
And it was like, man, this is a perfect way to cap off this record.
Put a bow on it.
I wanted to say this is what we needed to tempo, and I like what we've already said before, but this is what we needed.
We had two songs on the tracking day. We were looking for that ninth song. We had two songs, one that Kris and I wrote with Sue and Jason Cox.
Way worse than this.
Which you might get to hear one day. It's really fast.
You probably
Sue
won't.
Sue did good. The words that Sue wrote were great.
Yeah.
It's really fast, but it's one of those things. We didn't think it fit this album. We really didn't.
Yeah.
So then we go into the piano room, and we start singing Red Words with Wayne playing, y'all, and it was it was something special. I'll never forget that moment right there.
And we needed a Bible song.
We sang it for the first time.
We don't have one.
I don't think we've ever had an original Bible song.
So. I mean, guys, that's a little extreme.
Maybe some. We have plenty of songs that are literal scriptures.
About the Bible.
Talking about the Bible itself.
A song about the Bible. Okay.
And Barbara Huffman, we don't need to leave her out, just say her name and leave her out. She's written hundreds of songs
in
Christian music, and she's incredible. And this may be Barbara's first Erwin cut, so that's kind of cool. Aww. I may be wrong on that. Barbara can correct me, but I don't know. I think it is. I don't know, but Barbara's great, and you will see her name and all these names that we're reading on many, many other Christian records, and so we're thankful for that.
That's right. Number six. Walking Free, and it's words and music by Jeff Baumgartner, Trenton Fiscus, and Kris.
That's right.
Love
Jeff. Jeff's a dear friend. We've known him for years. He co-wrote Only Faith Can See. A
lot of songs for us. Only Faith and...
Believe Him, isn't it? Was it Believe Him? I know that was Sue. I don't know if we're being able to fact check that quickly.
You know what's really cool? So I'm just going to lay this out here. This is Cody's least favorite song.
I wasn't going to say it, Katie.
I'm going to say it for you.
I'll say it.
Because you're making a face that's...
I'm not trying to make a face or make a words, but I will
Cody's least favorite song on this album is Walking
Free.
It
has nothing to do with these people, talented people, and nothing to do with the quality of Zane's job. It's just something... You know, guys, here it is.
Tell me.
Pet peeve. We do a pet peeve segment.
That's right.
Here's a pet peeve for me. You know, and it's not a pet peeve. It's just my preference, which is neither here nor there. But... Guys, you just got a song on a record or hear a song, he's like, you know what? That's just not my favorite.
Oh, yeah.
Hey.
It's a fine song.
I get it completely.
Kris did a great job singing it.
I know.
They wanted me to sing it. Y'all wanted me to sing it. I say they because you're listening to me. They wanted me to sing it. And I didn't want to because it's just not my thing. It's not the song for me.
Well,
and that's okay.
Cody, if you're not walking free, that's okay.
It's a great word. It's not the word.
It's too late for that.
Hey, but you know what's really cool? Let me turn this around a little bit.
Please.
We have gotten some feedback on this album and like reviews and stuff. Walking Free has been one that they have all talked about. I'm not kidding. In a good way.
They're just saying that.
They have loved Walking Free.
I hope that this is like our first number one.
We have been told that this is like a Kane. Are We the Kingdom Phil song?
It does. It does sound like that.
And so
I'm we have yet to stage it. That's one of those songs at this point, in this particular position in the song.
You all listening, if you all ever come to hear us,
request.
We sing Walking Free. No, don't request it.
No.
Don't request it because we're already going to sing it. We're definitely going to. You may sing it twice.
It's true.
Okay?
Yep.
But I don't want you all just to sit there while we're singing Walking Free. If you're listening to
get
this podcast, you better
they're
show that
walk
you're
out.
Walking free. Okay? I want a heightened
walk
spirit.
Free, baby.
Get a
I
walk want a out. High, visibly heightened spirit during Walking Free. When
okay,
you
hear me out.
Live. You choose how, but I better
my
see
little
it.
Marketing brain is spinning right now. Are you ready for this?
Oh, boy.
Walking Free.
Walking shoes.
What do we need? We need Erwin tennis shoes.
Oh, absolutely.
Shoes.
Let's go.
We need Crocs.
Next.
Let's
get
Crocs. Even better.
Next song.
You guys, please let us know that you love this idea.
Look at the next one and who wrote it. Read those names out.
Number seven is Joy Is Gonna Come, words and music by Kenna Turner West, Jason Cox, Keith Erwin, Katie Erwin, Hedrick, and Kris Erwin. Not Kody.
That's right.
So you would think this would be my least favorite.
Yeah, because you're not getting...
It doesn't matter.
He ain't getting no royalties.
What was I doing? I don't think I can make it to Nashville that time.
You
nope.
You had to stay home.
You were watching the kiddos.
I think so.
I think Ivy had surgery.
You were walking free.
Could have been.
Something.
Okay.
Someone had surgery.
I hear what you did there.
So, yeah. So, I was just kind of banging on my guitar in the songwriting
really
process.
Were.
And maybe gave a word or two, but we were surrounded by legends.
This is a
all
song.
It takes.
Hey.
This
hey,
is
we
a really cool story, actually.
Legends.
We had, Katie and I, this was back when Katie lived at the house still, we would write together late at night, often.
Very often. Yeah. We have
go,
a
Logan.
Lot of things.
You ruined
yeah,
it.
Ruined
He's
it.
He's sitting in the room.
Yep. Say hi. Scream it.
Yeah.
There he is.
That's
that
him,
was
the ghost of Logan.
Loudest I've ever heard him.
Yep, that's right.
But we when Katie lived at the house, we wrote a lot together. And one night I came to her and said, I have this idea. And I had practically the chorus down. Like the pre-chorus that Katie sings and then the chorus. I had all that done. And then we worked on the chorus, didn't we?
You had the melody of the pre.
Yeah.
The actual pre-chorus. Hook, like the joy is going to come was my idea.
Yeah.
You had all the melody. Like you said a minute ago, you like doing melody.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm not great at words. I just kind of helped
was
a little bit.
Give the date.
In August
it's pretty
of 22?
Cool. Okay. No, it's August of 21. August 4th of 21. And we were in that, right?
23. It was 22 to 23.
There's no way it was 23 because we already had our songs down in August. We didn't just write Joy is going to come this past August. No.
Is that right?
That has to be 21 and 22. We didn't just finish Joy is going to come a couple months ago.
If y'all could see Chris's face right now,
I promise you, it's a shock face. So that's why broken. When we say this album has taken 3 years, it's not a lie. Like, it's legit. It's been almost...
I think she's right.
It's been almost 2 years since we finished writing Joy is going to come. Yeah. It's been almost 3 years since we started the process.
But anyway, give the date.
Yes. August 4th of 2021 is when we came up with this idea the night that Chris is talking about in his bedroom. And then exactly 365 years later, we find ourselves.
Oh, my 365
years, you said yours.
Oh, I meant days. Y'all, I have
We have aged very well, siblings.
We're talking about this record our 365 years later.
Right, that's why we call it life story.
It's gold.
It's generations.
365 days.
That's right.
Later, we find ourselves at Word writing for the new album.
And finishing the song.
And literally finishing the song. I found it in my notes. And I literally got chills in the room whenever I said...
You still have your notes in your phone?
I have it on my computer.
At that point, we did.
Yeah. But it shows the day that we started it. That was Chris's phone. It shows the day that we started and came up with the idea and the day we finished. And it's exactly 1 year later.
Isn't that incredible?
And that is so creepy. We did not plan that.
No, we didn't. We were sitting in the writing room.
Yep,
and
when
we
I
figured
found
that
out.
Because you were back on your notes that day.
What I just said, yep.
And it's incredible. Well, I just wanted to make sure that everybody was clear.
It's so real cool.
Yeah, it was an exactly year later.
Yep.
No, 365 years later.
Don't know if it was 21 to 22 or 22 to 23.
Listen,
it was 21 to 22.
This is a fun song.
The intro sounds like that.
Da, 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 oh well.
Jackson 5. Jackson 5.
Well, that too.
It doesn't matter. La, la, la. Oh well.
Yeah, something like that.
La, la.
Wasn't really intentional. Kind of accidentally did that. That wasn't how it was written.
It works.
There's another Easter egg.
Nope.
Okay, it's an Easter egg in the song.
Rasco 5.
Oh, Rasco 5.
Oh, wait.
Go ahead and say it.
That's all.
I wanted people to email us.
That's all we're going to say.
Yeah. Rasco Flat.
Yeah, Rasco Flat. Try to look that up.
Hey, I challenge you. Get in your car on a sunny, pretty day. Listen to the song. Roll the windows down. It's going to change your mood. If you're in a bad mood, turn the song on. It's going to help you.
It's going to help you.
It's going to help you. I challenge you.
That's good, Kody. You really just blessed us with that word. Thank
Joy
you for that.
Joy is going to come. All right. Number eight. One of my favorites as well. I Only Have the Cross to Blame.
Oh, my goodness.
Words and music by Joel Lindsay, Susie Smith, and Blake Walker. What a group.
Talking about some legends right there
what
with
a
Blake,
group.
Who is an up-and-coming writer. And like I said, a very anointed young man and doing some great writing. Sue Smith and Joel Lindsay have been around for years and years, and they are seasoned veterans of the writing industry, but incredible people.
We got to get Joel in here.
Oh, that would be fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
Because what's Dave Clark and Dusty Wells?
Dusty Wells. It's called...
I Love to Tell the Story.
I Love to Tell the Story. That's a plug for another podcast. Look up
so
I Love to Tell
good.
The Story. Two guys that have been in the industry for years and years. And they recorded a Joel Lindsay episode. Incredible.
Yes, it is.
And so look that up. But yes, that'd be a good idea. We'd love to have Joel on here.
He wrote Power of an Empty Tomb.
Yes, he
for
did.
Us.
And this was our first... song to sing on during the record. It was early on a Thursday?
Maybe so.
Wednesday, I think. I don't know.
It was one of the days.
One of the days of the week. And it just kind of organically, whatever the computer has pulled up, software pulls up, what song you want to do, kind of how we do it. We don't have some people, I'm sure, have a more organized way. We don't. Anyway, Wayne's like, I only have the cross to blame. And I was blessed to be able to sing on it, and it was a little bit high. My bass register is perfect in the morning, which I like to sing in the morning. And
it's perfect.
His mic's not on. Wait, his mic's not on.
There you can say it now. He looked right at me and he said, like by the way, it's perfect in the morning. Just
I wish Jared Dixon was here.
I meant
it's
my perfect in the morning. It's the best I can do in the morning.
Yeah.
But I don't sing bass on this song. I sing a little bit higher for me. And
we'll do it every Sunday morning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they threw me in the fire early.
And I'll tell you one thing. We've staged this song twice now at the same place, two nights in
That's
a row.
Right.
Powerful.
Oh, yeah.
Powerful.
And
I
want to
not wait to see what God's going to do.
I want to go back to Kody. I want to brag on him for a minute. This is the best vocal Kody has ever done.
Yep. Yeah, I don't think.
I agree.
It is.
I agree with him.
Joseph Habedank said the same thing.
I don't like giving him compliments, but I'm giving him one right now.
Thank you, guys.
It's the best vocal Kody's ever done.
Well, I'm not getting, you're not going to get me singing that high that early often.
We'll just have to see.
Well, it's my least favorite song on the album.
Yeah, Kris, that's just your...
I think everyone's going to skip it. I think no one cares about it, and I've heard nothing but bad things. Yep. Except for the Riders. They're amazing.
Yes, they are.
And the bridge is my favorite part, y'all. Yeah. I will say,
there's countless songs about the cross that we can all name. We all probably have our favorite just song about the cross. There's plenty of them. But this one, it has a really cool angle. Yeah,
that's right.
You blame the cross for the victory we have. It's amazing to think about it at that angle. Only Sue and Blake Joel. And Joel can put that together.
Twist it like that.
That's cool.
The my favorite line in the song is the start of the bridge, as Kody said, "I only had the cross to blame for the nights I sleep in peace."
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I accused the crown of thorns for the hope that rescued me.
Oh, my soul.
I only have his bleeding side to charge for everlasting life, and every blessing, big and small, it's not my fault. That's the bridge.
Because I've been rescued. That's a great song. Pretty amazing.
And I got chills.
The arrangement of Wayne, how it comes, like Katie said, right out of the chorus, right in. You don't even know
that it's going into the bridge.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing.
It is. One of my favorites.
Cannot wait to see what God's going to do
with
that.
The final song, which was one of the last ones that we also picked for this album. Redwoods was probably the last.
Was it?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, it was next to last, I believe. Yeah. It's called Fighting for You, and it's words and music by Michael Farren, Kenna Turner West, and Jason Crabb.
Jason Crabb, his first Erwin cut.
Yeah. Mm.
Thank you, Jason, for not cutting this song. Yeah.
Thank you. We do appreciate that you gave it to us.
Michael Farren, a Texas boy, raised in Northeast Texas, has written songs
for
everybody. Incredible writer.
And the Erwins finally got one.
Yes, the Erwins got one. We love him. We love Michael. And, of course, Kenna was the bridge to this song and for us. And, no stranger to this podcast. That's no stranger to us. And, it's just it's a promise from our Lord that he's fighting our battles. Mm. And my goodness, it's strong. This is another song at this point in this season, as we stand here today. We've not staged it yet. But we cannot wait to see what God's going to do with this record and this song particularly.
I want to hear a Jason Crabb feature.
Ooh, good idea.
On this
maybe
song.
Digital EP or something.
Yeah. That would be really cool. Yeah.
Be a good idea.
That'd be super, super cool. We're in Nashville a lot, so we can just get him to come into the studio.
If he's willing.
That's right.
That'd be super cool to do a little version with him.
Hillbillies.
He's from Kentucky, man.
That's right. That's right. He's used to it.
I hope that this album ministers to you guys like no other album has from the Erwins. I hope this is your new favorite.
No other album. This is going
to
be the one that does.
I hope you have it on replay and repeat for a long time. Let us know what your favorite song is.
Please do.
Like I asked in the beginning of this.
Please do. All have any questions about a certain song, about anything, let us know.
And go stream it. Go stream it.
Share it. Stream it.
Share it. Tell everyone. We would be so humbled that if you guys would do that.
Yes.
Share your favorite song.
We work really hard, and I know a lot of other people work really hard on this record. Mm-hmm. It's been a 3-year journey, and we are here. We've made it, and so now we just kind of give it to the Lord and see what he does with it.
We've shared our life story.
That's it.
This is it.
And everybody has a story. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I think this album could help people, maybe open up and tell them, what their story is.
That's it.
For sure.
I mean, I don't think it's a coincidence that we did... Still Telling My Story, and then the title is called Life Story. Still Telling My Story was the first cut of an album, the longest.
We cut Still Telling My Story before we knew the album.
Exactly.
Title.
Yeah. I don't think that's a coincidence.
True. Well, I said 3 years, but Kody said it's been 365 years since.
Hey, now.
So it's been
I'll
a
never
long
live that
time.
One
is
down.
Relative.
Time is relative. It's a flat circle, but I've heard.
Oh, man.
It's relative.
But guys, yes, please let us know. We'd love to have your feedback. Again, the email address, the word for, F-O-U-R, the letter K, the word pod, 4kpod@yahoo.com. We would love to get your input and or anything, prayer requests, anything. Tell me if you want it private. We just read it to ourselves. But if you want it public, we'd love to tell your story on our podcast. And so, or your comments, your questions, everything you have for us. It's a great treat for us to do this podcast and for you all to have interest in it. So we thank you for everything.
And you know,
go ahead, brother.
No, you please.
I would be. I'd be honored if you went.
Wow! Someone go.
I'm going to walk free and go.
Ooh. Oh,
if you could hear the tales of where I have been.
I was going to just say, Kris, that if we're in our area, come hear these songs live.
That's exactly right.
We would love to meet you.
ErwinMinistries.com is where you can order a physical copy of this CD and where you can see our tour dates. ErwinMinistries.com.
It is awesome listening to it, streaming, or in your car, especially or working out, or whatever. But if we are in your area... That's we right. will try come to do walk it
free.
Justice.
Come with here Erwin's. Walking free live.
That's Let's it. Go. Yep. We'll have the Crocs, the tennis shoes.
I will
shoes.
Say kind of a funny story. We wanted Fighting For You. We were thinking about doing Fighting For You as the album cover and then us in boxing gloves. That would be kind of play on.
We could sell Tug boxing gloves.
Yes.
We can sell boxing sell gloves,
sell boxing though. Gloves that say Fighting For You in the Bible That's verse actually of really fighting cool. our battles.
Logan, I think Logan likes that idea. I got a chuckle out of my husband. Oh,
he's a black belt.
Hey, we haven't. Let's mention this real fast. A lot of people are asking who's the new guy on the album cover.
Yes.
That's my husband.
Yes, that's right.
He's not
we put him on the cover just in time to put him on the soundboard.
That's right, well, brother.
He's doing a great job. I'm proud of him. And I'm very happy that he's on there. He looks so handsome.
Oh, Logan is a Swiss Army knife. He does everything and does everything well and very low maintenance. And he's awesome.
And
he's
if you have trouble walking free at our concerts, Logan. We have a nurse.
Come here, Logan.
He's a nurse
Come here, Logan.
Yeah, we have a registered nurse on hand.
If you Logan, break a bone.
Accept our great thanks.
What's your favorite song on the album?
And what is your least favorite song walking free?
Let's go. No pressure.
Oh, that's really hard to choose. I don't know.
Well, you're on the album.
Louder.
Let me turn on the album.
I really like Red Words.
Mm. Hey, he picked his last
Red
White. Song.
You got to pick a different one.
His last song.
It's hard, though, because I want to pick them all because they're all awesome. All
right. What's your least favorite?
I don't think I have a least favorite.
Yeah, you do.
Which Logan. Is the one that you're going to skip? Which is the one that you're going to have next?
Yeah, you do.
No skips.
Oh, boy. We love
no
you
skips.
All.
Brother yep. Logan.
Thanks for listening to this podcast. We love you on 4Ks in a Pod.
Absolutely.
So much.
They're telling a story.
We'll see you next time.
God bless.
Jesus loves you. Bye-bye.
Thanks for joining us for this episode, and please take a moment to follow us on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, or wherever you listen to podcasts. It would be really helpful and appreciated if you could leave us a 5-star review and share this podcast with your friends. Also, if you want to reach out to the Erwins with any questions, comments, or feedback about the podcast, simply send an email to 4kpod@yahoo.com. That's forkpod@yahoo.com. You can also see the show notes for that email address, and we're really excited to hear from you. And you never know, if you send an email with a question, it may just be featured on a future episode. This podcast is hosted by Keith, Kody, Kris, and Katie Erwin, and it's produced by myself, Luke Clayton, and my team at mustincrease.com. Thank you once again for joining us for this episode, and we look forward to seeing you next time right here on 4Ks in a Pod with the Erwins.
Bring on the fire! Bring on the rain. My testimony is not gonna change. From the valley to the mountain, he's worthy of praise. Whatever comes before me, I'm still telling my story. Whatever comes before me, I'm still telling my story. Still telling my story.